welcome to your yin practice. And there may be some elements of restorative yoga as part of it as well. For this practice, I always recommend, regardless of how restorative or yin it might be, to have the use of two bolsters, two foam blocks, and two chip foam blocks. Certainly, one chip foam block will do the trick. In the practice today, I'd like to talk about the power of self-love and acceptance. I find no matter how much we as humans may build up our self-confidence and self-esteem, etc., that sometimes it can just be daunting and sometimes troubling when we get into our own self-doubt or lack of self-worth. Sometimes it's not easy rolling out of bed and putting on your shoes or your clothing and going out in society with your head high, your heart high and bright, or simply the confidence within yourself to know that you are enough for whoever and wherever you present yourself. And of course, we take accountability for the actions or for the feelings or for the thoughts we have, whether if it's about ourselves or about something outside of ourselves, for sure. But that doesn't mean that everything is dandy or that everything is simple or easy, just because we might take that accountability or take action to make whatever scenarios we might go through that we are less happy with, make them more content. And it's times like right now where we need to remember where the love within ourselves lies and where it lives, and to extract that and to lead with that light that truly is the essence of who we are as human beings. So may this practice be an opportunity or an invitation to delve beyond what we see and deeply into what we can feel, and to help ourselves heal in whatever symbolism or interpretation that might look like to our unique, individual, beautiful selves. So we'll start in a seated meditation if you're not already. And if you prefer to lie on your back, please feel welcome to lie on your back with any amount of support in the form of bolsters or pillows. And if you're okay seated and your knees are comfortable, let your body be still. Tip your pelvis forward and lengthen your tailbone back. Feel that lifting through the crown of your head. Slight firming of your navel and your ribcage to support the back of the body. And inhale through the nose and exhale through the nose. One breath option is to inhale for 4 and exhale for 6. A slightly longer exhale to help our bodies be comfortable letting go. Place your left hand over your heart, observing the sensations of the heartbeat. And your right palm over your belly, feeling the connection of the energy that lives within the hands and how they connect through the belly and through the chest. Alignment. Taking another breath here. And then we'll take the sound of Om, keeping our hands where they're placed. Inhale to begin. Release your hands to your thighs. You can keep your eyes closed for a short while if you like, as you bring your left ear towards your left shoulder, feeling the right side of your neck lengthen. You can tent your right fingertips out to your right side in line with your hip as you push the finger pads down and out to the right and breathe into the side of the neck. Releasing the jaw and any tension around the throat. Very slowly, roll your chin down to your chest. Right ear to your right shoulder, bring your right hand to your right knee, take your left fingertips out to the left, arriving into your second side. Taking another breath here. Very kindly roll your chin down towards your chest. Roll your head. then take both hands back to your knees. Good. We'll take a gentle twist by taking the right hand to the left thigh and the left hand behind you. Press down through your sitting bones and through your hands as you lengthen up the crown of your head. Exhale to the left, rotating the axis of the spine. Breathing into that space deep within, shedding any layers, bringing more light. Inhale to center. With the left hand on your left knee, take your right hand behind and counter the twist over to the right. Place your left hand to your right thigh, plant your right fingertips behind you, and inhale, lift up. And then gently exhale, revolve your spine to the right, twisting to the other side. Inhale to center. Exhale, sigh. And then take your right hand on your right knee, left hand behind you, counter twist and open twist to your left. Inhale, starting to turn. Exhale, just a little more nudge to the left. Center. Exhale, sigh. From here, place your feet to the floor, your hands behind you, and then let your knees windshield wiper from side to side just to release anything that may have come up for you in your hips and your lower back because you've been sitting for a little period of time now. Make your way to your hands and your knees. And as you find your way to your hands and your knees, go ahead and take your bolster off to the side. And then locate your two foam blocks and place them at the top right corner of the mat. And then take a chip foam block in front as well, just for good measure. As you arrive to your hands and your knees, just finding a little bit of cat and cow, moving freely with your breath and keeping your belly drawn in just slightly towards your lower back.
Thank you.
starting to move your body from side to side, getting into the lateral flexion, so more space between the ribs. Going to the other side. Taking a couple more to either side. And then we'll take our hands and face the fingers towards the knees, the wrists, the front of the mat, to open up through the forearms and the heart chakra, heart meridian, getting into more energy through the body, hands and the feet. Really hold a lot of energy that can be stagnant. So we want to open those channels, those nadis, lines of energy up to help us continue that exploration into our deeper fascial layers in the body, our connective tissues. Never feeling pain or any kind of response in the body that indicates a fight or a flight or a freeze or a submit in any way, shape, or form. Slowly begin to bring your hips to your heels, peeling your wrists off the ground, and then one finger pad at a time as well. And then you can let your palms face up and come into a modified child's pose for a moment. To your hands and your knees, and take the tops of the hands down, the palms of the hands up. Breathing in here. Again, come back, roll the wrists around in one direction and the other direction. Interlacing the hands, push your palms forward and round your spine. Breathe into the space around the shoulder girdle. Sighing it out. Come forward to your hands and your knees once more. Now from here, walk your hands forward, slide your hips back and up, finding a back bend, mounting heart. Your forehead be heavy, toes tuck. You can always support the forehead with your forearm by bending an elbow underneath your forehead. And breathe in here. Sighing it out.
taking another breath here. And carefully from there, keep reaching your arms forward, bring your chest forward until you can come onto your thighs. And find your way now into a Sphinx posture. So flowing into Sphinx. Letting the forearms come down. The tops of the feet down the mat. Push back to the tops of your toes. Spread your toes wide. Lengthening your sternum forward and up for a little back bend. And press down through your pubic bone, your waist bone, the ilium. So we can get into the lower back, the sacrum. Breathing in here. There's this comfort in the body or in the mind that's completely okay. Continue to bring yourself that quality of love, acceptance, embracing whatever is moving through you is the way it is meant to be, and it shall pass if it's needed to. If you would like to explore seal posture, be very kind as you start to plant your palms, extend your elbows, and lift your sternum and chest a bit higher, pressing down through the tops of your feet, tops of your toes, inhale and lengthen out through your crown of your head.
continue being aware if the sensations ever reach any concepts of pain. If anything comes up for you, be very mindful of what those things might be and breathe into them as need be. Then come out of the posture, lower your elbows down first. Stack your palms second, and then roll your chest and spine down last. Let your toes turn in and your heels turn out. And take a moment to breathe into your belly and into your waist. From there, take your arms out in line to a T shape. Take your left palm next to your left side of your chest. Roll onto your right hip, stacking your left hip on top of your right hip. Step your left foot in front of your right knee. And then I recommend the use of a block to rest the right side of the face on, just for comfort and for the neck support. And you can reach your left arm up to the ceiling, turn your left palm away. Take the top of the left hand to the low back. If you would like to add a little bit more intensity, but not to the point of no return, go ahead and lift your right hip bone off the ground, threading the left fingers underneath the right hip, and lean back, roll back. And then breathing and experiencing. And if you feel you need to come out earlier, just make your way to your belly into a prone position. Gently breathe in and around your right arm and shoulder girdle.
taking another breath here. Roll away from the palm to lift the left arm back up to the ceiling. Bring your left palm down and stack your legs, making your way back onto your belly. And your right arm come behind you, left arm come behind you. Just breathe, letting the right arm settle. Place your right hand inside of the right side of the chest. Your left arm out to the left, roll on the left hip, right hip on top of left hip. Place the right sole of the foot down in front of the left knee, sliding that block underneath the left side of your cheek. Inhale, reach your right arm up overhead. Turn the palm away, let the top of the hand come up to the low back. Roll forward onto your left hip and lift the hip and slide and position the left hip over top of the right hand. Breathing in. Breathing out.
here. Release your right hand from your left hip. Release your right arm up to the ceiling. Placing the right palm down, sack the legs. Carefully release the pressure of the left side. Be very, very careful as you come back to neutral. Taking the left palm face up, down by the side, as well as the right. Your legs flop out, and your chest, your chin come heavy. Take your arms out in front of you, press down to come up to your hands and knees. And then we'll find a toe squat. So bring your bum to your heels. Bring your bum to your heels and tuck the toes underneath you. And then just kind of feel it out and see if you need to bring, if you have a bolster, then you can take a bolster between the bum and the heels, which might be a bit more comfort for you. Also give a little bit more support. Okay, you can have your palms facing down on your quads. Roll your shoulders back. The crown of the head, feel that lengthening from the tailbone. Place your left hand again on the heart and the right hand on the belly, coming back to that centering inward. Breathing gently into either hand. Feeling the rise and the fall of either. Here for a few more breaths. Release your hands to your thighs and blink the eyes open. Release your palms down in front. Let your toes come off the ground and let them be still so your circulation can return and regulate through the body. You can wiggle the toes, the feet, roll the ankles around as well. Take the tops of your feet down with your legs, your shins, your knees touching. Tent your fingertips on either side of you And as you roll your shoulders back and firm your belly, just apply enough pressure into the tops of the feet and the ankles a bit to lift the shins for an ankle stretch. And then that'll help counter from our toe squat. Inhale. And return back to your shins. Shift your weight to your left or right side and swing your legs out in front of you. And tap out your legs and your calves. Fantastic. So grab your blocks that are at the front of the mat. Take them to your right side. And then finding a bolster now beneath your knees or thighs. From there, send your legs out more extended in front of you, focusing on the hamstrings. You can sit on a chip foam block if you wish, or keep your sit bones on your mat. Inhale and reach your arms out and up overhead. Exhale, come forward into caterpillar position, a seated forward fold, and don't worry about how much the spine rounds, except the chest, the neck, and the head relax. Breathing in. And breathing out. Inhale, roll yourself up. Exhale, sigh out your mouth. And we'll set up for a supported fish position. We're using our two foam blocks, more traditional yin supported fish. So you require two blocks, and you can take the first block horizontally, back of the mat, and a little space with the other block closer to you vertically. So that way the back of the block will come behind the back of the skull, and the block that's close to you will come between your shoulder blades. You can always lay on one of your bolsters vertically and lay it against your sacrum if you prefer this, or taking my lead, aiming your shoulders around the block, letting the shoulders roll back, and taking the base of the skull over top of the block. And then your feet can be flat with the knees pointing up. You can always take your feet together, your knees wide. That might be too much for some bodies, some people, and that's fine. So you can always keep your feet flat or even extend your legs out long if that's preferred. If you have a bolster and you'd like to apply it over top of your hips, this might add a little bit of extra sensation for a deeper inner thigh groin release. When we feel feelings of self-doubt or lesser feeling of worth, whether it's about ourselves or other things in life, the world or other people, whether if it's a projection of not feeling something within what we're actually going through, or if it's from a place of confidence and just stating the fact of what we believe our perception is of what it is that we are being critical to. The beauty of a yin and slower, deeper practice gives light and awareness on those subjects or those focuses which may be a little bit more submerged, subconscious, subterranean. So allow your props, your blocks to open, to bring a bit more of a crack for the light to shine through it. Like a cat's eye. It's a little sliver. A possibility, an opportunity, for whatever it might be. moments here. Bolster if you have one. You take your head in the support of your left palm, roll off your blocks to the left side carefully, and tuck your knees into your chest and bring your chin towards your heart, breathing into your back body. To your backs, and take your blocks off to the side, and then hug your knees in towards your chest, chin to throat. One more breath here. Chest and your head back down, and then I like to take a couple bolsters, stacking them over top of another horizontally, setting the legs over top for a more restorative shavasana. And if you have an eye cover, feel welcome to use that eye cover over the forehead without harming your eyes or any of the tissue around the eyes. Your palms face up, down by your sides. Everything relax. And then let all that work you've provided your body, your mind, your spirit, let that all come and bubble to the surface. Breathe into the dark, into the deep spaces, and shine more light. The symbol of yin is black. It resembles the shadows and the mysteries, the enshrouded. Let the inhale represent the yang, the light, the white, the blowing of the sand off the treasure box to reveal what lies inside the chest. Unlocking, opening through the hands and feet, the wrists and the ankles. Expanding in all directions through your limbs and joints. Feel that lightness, that expansion as you expand, breathe in. Letting it go. Release your eye cover to the side if it's in use. Roll over to your left side into fetal position. And breathe. Place your right palm and your left palm down to the floor, pressing up to your seat. Use your chip foam block and sit on top. Placing the left hand on the heart, the right hand on the belly again. Take the time to sift through the layers upon the layers. We find those sweet little rays of light and reflection that respond to us by doing the work of self-discovery, self-acceptance, self-empowerment, self-love, our self-study, svadhyaya. Inhale, Om. You are worthy of everything that you desire. Don't get in your own way of what it is that you want and that you know you are worth. Namaste.